Now we will practice finding a loop condition using the second loopy question. Does it stop right? Does the opposite of the loop condition, B, combined with the invariant, P, imply that the post condition, R, is true? To do this, we actually look for not B, such that we make this expression true. We can then negate this to get the actual loop condition, B. Here are the invariant, P, and post condition, R, for our first example. P is, S is the sum of m dot dot k minus 1, combined with, k is at least m and at most n. R is, S is the sum of m dot dot n minus 1. Knowing that P is true, and doing some pattern matching with P and R, we can see that R is true if k equals n. This means that not B is k equals n. Negating that, we can see that B is k does not equal n. Looking at the restriction on k in invariant P, we could instead write the loop condition as k is less than n if we want. Either of these loop conditions here will work in this case. Now let's look at a second example. P is, V is the minimum of B sub 0 dot dot k minus 1, and k is at least 0 and at most n. R is, V is the minimum of B sub 0 dot dot n minus 1. Just as in the last example, knowing P is true, we can see that R is true when k equals n. This gives us the same result for not B, and thus the same loop condition, B, as well. Again, we can use the bound on k in the invariant to show that either of these options is correct for the loop condition. Now let's look at a third example. P is b to the power of c equals z times x to the power of y combined with y is at least 0. R is z is equal to b to the power of c. Using pattern matching again, we can see that R will be true when P is true and x to the power of y equals 1. We know that x to the power of y equals 1 when y equals 0. Thus, not B is y equals 0, and our loop condition is y does not equal 0. The next two exercises are for you. Find the loop condition using pattern matching and the second loopy question, as we did here. The answers are in the document that accompanies this video.